wondering if you could explain the hadith about naqisat aql, that women are deficient in their intelligence.
What's the meaning of this hadith that naqisat aql, deficient in their intelligence? I'm not sure if I would translate it intelligence and deficient. There are, but that's a common translation. In Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam explained what this means. He said, because in the testimonial, we will have two, because of the memory, two versus one. And the reason, because at that time, women usually don't deal witness. When you say I'm a witness, it means I am aware of all the details. Shahada shaheed, okay? Fastashiru shaheedayni min rijalikum. Shaheed, it means someone who knows the details, that Allah calls shaheed. We don't call Allah shahid. Shaheed, it means a one who knows so much details. Shahid has a general idea, okay? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the woman when it comes to the business transaction, shahidayni min rijalikum, because these have to know all the details and all the smallest details of the transactions. And this is usually doesn't happen for women, especially in the time these verses were revealed, because women go and they're not known to be part of these detailed transactions that are taking place at that time. That's why you will need two women to remember, so they will remind each other of the detail of the business transaction. Usually you have very good memory of the thing that you do a lot. And in that society in particular, the people who deal with business a lot are men, not women. So because of that, it was required for two women to witness over the business transactions. And because of that reason, when it comes to general areas, like testimonial, for example, in murder, many ulama will say one woman will be equal to one man. And some scholar will say that. When it comes to witnessing the entering of the month, the newborn crescent, you know, a man and a woman equal to each other. There is no proof to differentiate between them. That ayah was specific. So in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was telling Aisha radiallahu anha, that if there is a deficiency, it's because of this ruling when it comes to the testimonial, when it comes to the issue of the business transaction. But if we look at what is the story behind the hadith, the story behind Hadith Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't say it in a way that to make fun of women or to point out deficiency in women or to say women are less than men. The hadith never came at all like that. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi said to her, لَمْ أَرَ مِثْلَكُنْ نَاقِصَاتُ عَقْلٍ وَدِينٍ يَأْخُذْنَ بِلُبِّ الرَّجُلِ اللَّبِيبِ. I never see one like you, even though with this deficiency, with this ruling, even though with your, the deen, the deficiency in religion, because she prayed half of the amount of prayers that men pray because of her menses. But that's not in reality deficiency, because it doesn't mean that the woman is sinning or wrong or her iman is not complete by not praying. If she prays, well, she has menses, she committed sin. She's not praying, and by not praying, she's obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah ordered her not to pray. So here he's saying, with all this, but you still manage to take over the heart and the mind of the one who sees himself the smartest person in the world. And we think we're smarter than you, but you still can take over and control any man that you wish or you want. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that's how the hadith comes. In that context, never ever in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ever said a statement that anybody understood from it that he wants to put women down or to undermine them or to say that they are less or men better than them in that sense. No. And I think a lot of it to do with culture. This kind of expressions, you know, in Arabic cultures, in the culture of Arabia, many things are acceptable. Not acceptable for us, many things acceptable in our culture today wouldn't be acceptable 100 years ago, wouldn't be acceptable in Middle Eastern culture or Chinese culture or Indian culture. Sometimes we just find ourselves, we think we're the only one in the world. That's not true. There is different culture, different way of talking. Words and statements can have different sense completely from one time to another, from one place to another. I give you an example. You know, in Arabic culture, for instance, if you keep saying to someone, please give me this, please do this, may I do this, I will feel that, what's wrong with you? That's not a nice way to talk to me. Can you believe that? Every time you talk to me, you tell me, please, may I, Madri, you feel like, ah, this is so like formal and like not friendly, and لو سمحت من فضلك, you know, it became too much. We just have this, give me this, take this. It's direct talk. Nobody ever feel insulting. Pick this from the floor. Here, if you say that in English culture, you feel like this is an insulting way of talking. This can giving me orders, you know, bossing me around. It's completely different culture. Oh my God, you say in Arabic, no thank you? What's wrong with you? But you know, it is too much talk, too much talk. That's in our culture. That's why when translate from Arabic to English, it became a problem. Language is a culture. And I think that's one of the biggest challenges when we translate the deen to a different language. That sometimes we translate, we don't know how to differentiate between the culture of the Arabic language from that language itself, and how we make it sound acceptable in the new culture that I'm proposing or introducing this religion to it. And that's an area it's really worth looking into it and explore it, how Muslims did it in the past with new and different cultures when they interacted with them.
Every question ever asked about women's fiqh is answered in this online course. But if you want to challenge that, you have live Q&A sessions to ask what hasn't already been asked. Click on the button and get access to your student portal before that window closes.